If you're interested in doing the Grandmaster Nightfall this week, it's totally possible with a budget build, which means we made a guide on how to complete it using only seasonal gear or very accessible gear that anybody should be able to get this season. Okay, so first up, I'm going to show the builds that we use to complete the Grandmaster, and then I'm going to go into tips on areas of the Grandmaster that might provide difficulty without the right advice. Okay, so first up, the Warlock was using a 2-minute of Grace for Well of Radiance to keep us all healed and damage buffed. He was using Long Shadow, a sniper rifle anybody can get from any strike, Risk Runner, which everybody gets at the beginning of the campaign, and Royal Entry, which is a random strike drop. He was using double rocket launcher scavenger on his helmet, and he was using the Aeon Soul Gauntlets, which are very useful. Anytime you finish a champion, you get heavy ammo, and anytime you finish an orange bar enemy, you get special ammo. He had on Overload SMG and Anti-Barrier Sniper Rifle. In order to get the heavy ammo to spawn, make sure you have on Sect of Insight. He had Arc Resistance and Sniper Resistance on his robes, which is very important, and on his legs, he had a Rocket Launcher Scavenger and High Energy Fire, so anytime he's charged with light, he's doing more damage. And then he had Powerful Friends on his bond. We were okay with recommending this because it was recently sold at the Gunsmith. Our first Titan was using Code of the Commander with Ursa Furiosa, which is really important to have for Grandmasters, and he was using the Whispering Slab Bow, which is a world drop from anywhere. He had Quick Draw and Demolitionist, so he got grenades a bit faster, and then he had Borealis, which is a random sniper drop anybody can get. Borealis is particularly good because you can damage any shield type, and if you break a shield type, it transfers a bullet from reserves. He also had on Code Duello, which is a rocket launcher anybody can get out of an Umbral Engram. On his helmet, he just had a rocket launcher ammo finder, and we're only using Charge with Light mods that everybody has access to, and then he had an Overload Bow mod and an Anti-Barrier Sniper Rifle. On his chest, he had Arc Resistance and Melee Resistance, both very important for this, and then on his legs, he had Rocket Launcher Scavenger and Powerful Friends. Again, we're only recommending Charge with Light mods that are accessible, so that one was recently sold, and other ones, like Taking Charge, High Energy Fire, and Shield Break Charge, those are actually in your inventory when you create a new account. I was using the Dead Man's Tail Scout Rifle, which anybody can get through that seasonal presage mission. If you don't have it, other scout rifles certainly work fine as well, like Nightwatch or whatever else you have, really. I was using Imperial Needle, which is a bow anybody can get out of an Umbral Engram, and Code Duello, which is the same. Just get it from an Umbral, and you can focus it for Code Duello specifically if you level up your Wartable reputation. On my helmet, I was using ammo finders for my rocket and my scout rifle so I never ran out of ammo, and then on my arms, Ursa Furiosa's, I was using Overload Bow and Anti-Barrier Scout Rifle, and this mod called Font of Might, where if I pick up an elemental well that matches my subclass, which is a void, it buffs my void damage weapons, which is my bow, so that's kind of useful. Not really important, just a fun little extra thing. Here's another elemental well mod from the war table that I was using. Again, not terribly important, it just spawns an elemental well that matches my subclass, so I get a void elemental well, and then that in turn helps Font of Might. And I had on double arc resist, which was really useful. Then I had scavengers for my rocket and my scout and high energy fire. And on my mark, I just had mods to improve my ability regeneration and get some primary ammo back using finishers. All right, next up, some generalized advice for each area of the Nightfall. First up, the Warsat area. As soon as you come in, don't sparrow up to the Warsat right away. Get off your sparrow and walk up and don't get too close to it. When the Warsat falls down from the sky, it's going to do a huge explosion, and if you're anywhere near it, it'll kill you. Then you need to back up to the back of the map and shoot off the skiff turrets right away. Those things will wreck you, but your primary weapons can take them out if you just team shoot together. After that, hang back and let the enemies come to you. We like to go very far away, and we don't ever stand on the Warsat until we're ready to spawn a new wave of enemies. As you progress the Warsat, it's going to spawn new enemies. So only stand on it when you're really ready for the next wave, otherwise you're gonna get overwhelmed. After enough spawns and enough time has progressed on the Warsat, you're gonna get the next two ships to spawn, which is what you see on screen now, that's the stage that we're fighting, and you're gonna get a barrier champion to spawn. In the last wave, you would have seen an overload champion spawn out, but this time it's a barrier, and in the final stage, it's another overload. Again, you're going to need to back up pretty far and team shoot any of the turrets before you engage these enemies up close. Make sure to use your supers and your ammo. You're going to get plenty of heavy back from your Warlock doing special finishes with their Aeon Gauntlets, and the Titans can just keep chaining Ursa Furiosa over and over again, and it's totally fine to just burn all of your supers here. Maybe be a little bit more conservative with ammo, but for the most part, it's just worth not dying, and you're always going to get ammo and abilities back faster than you think, so just use it. It's worth it. Okay, so this next room, I actually think it's the hardest part of the whole Nightfall. We like to just run in, right up, and go in this left area right here, where we pop a Titan shield, and then use that to deflect these shanks and the enemies that spawn behind us, which are a couple vandals, but they're kind of confused when they spawn in because usually guardians aren't supposed to be here, so their pathing gets messed up, so they're not really able to fight you very well, especially if you just put an Ursa shield right on them. You can chain the Ursa shields and put up Titan walls, and this area becomes very defensible easily. The enemies are not very well programmed to aggress to you if you're standing here, so it really shouldn't be too much of a problem. They'll probably actually just walk out of the room and then try to fight you. Just be coordinated and shoot the same thing at the same time, and then when you're ready to deal with champions after taking out some of the enemies to your right and behind you, then make sure you're team shooting and chaining Ursas. The champions might get a little bit tough to hit behind the pillar, but it'll work out at the end, and you should be taking enough damage on your Ursa Furiosas that you can just keep chaining them back to back. Also, even when an enemy is being defended by the barrier servitor, they're still vulnerable to Ursa damage, so if you kind of walk up there and are tagging enemies with Ursa damage, even when they're in the barrier servitor's shield, they will die eventually, so that can be useful to kind of push up aggressively with an Ursa. You'll have an overload here too, but just focus on the barrier first. The overload will be putting in plenty of valuable damage into your Ursa Furiosas to give you your super energy back. After you kill the barrier, you're going to spawn tracer shanks and another overload behind you. Just focus on the overload in front of you first, and then the other guys. Your Ursa Furiosa and your Well of Radiance should be able to keep you alive here. Then you can focus on the tracer shanks behind you and the overload captain. Once you kill the overload captain, it's not going to spawn anything else, so just take it slow here and don't use up a revive if you don't have to. If through any point of this you feel that you're becoming overwhelmed, you can just go back into your hidey hole in the hallway there and you'll be totally fine. Then once you activate the next spawn of enemies, pop an Ursa Furiosa pretty much right away, and a Well of Radiance. Now this is important, if you're blocking with Ursa, you can't stand in the Well of Radiance, otherwise it won't give you shield energy back. So it's really important to stand just outside of the Well of Radiance while you're blocking with your Ursa. Here you can see a good example of chaining Ursas back to back, where because the Titans are talking to each other and giving each other timers about when their Ursa is about to run out, you're never unshielded, because the Titans can just pop them back to back and keep you shielded the whole time. This should allow you to kill all the smaller adds, and then you can focus on the overloads. There's one in the way back, and then there's one on the upper left. Now this is a good time to mention that the double Ursa build is sort of a signature staple of Grandmaster Nightfalls. People have been using these forever and it's really nothing unique, but it's a very safe way to do Grandmasters, and if you don't have Ursas, I actually am not quite sure whether or not you would want to try out a Grandmaster if you're new to them, because it's just so unbelievably safe to use two Ursa Furiosas in a Grandmaster. So if you don't have Ursa Furiosas, I'm terribly sorry that I've now recommended them in a budget build where it was supposed to be accessible. However, there is a way to get Ursa Furiosas. However, there is a way to get Ursa Furiosa gauntlets. If you're a Titan, go to a legendary lost sector when it's dropping arms. These are located on the moon, or maybe by the time you're watching it in a different season, they're located elsewhere, but if you farm a legendary lost sector when it says the exotic chance is to drop arms, then it does have a chance to drop Ursa Furiosas for your Titan, so I highly recommend picking those up. I make a budget build pretty much every week for the Grandmaster just to show that it really is possible to do even if you're new or you don't have great loot, and we recommend Ursa Furiosas in almost every budget build just because they are so safe, and a lot of people do have them. They were also recently sold at Xur. When I say recently, I think that was a couple weeks ago, but still, quite a few people have them. If you feel that this isn't accessible, as always, please let me know, because the whole point of these videos is to make accessible guides for anyone to be able to do the Grandmaster. So if you have any suggestions on how I can improve these videos, I'm always all ears. Okay, moving on to other advice. In that long room when you're defending yourself against shanks and moving the electric ball down the hallway, what we do is we pop a Well of Radiance at the final area where you deposit the ball, and then we chain Ursa Furiosas down the whole length of that area. So one Titan defends the other Titan as he's carrying the ball. And meanwhile, the Warlock is shooting the exploder shanks as a priority right when they spawn. There's going to be two exploders that spawn at the same time, so the Warlock needs to shoot those first, and then he can focus on the smaller shanks. The other two rooms after these honestly do not provide too much of a problem. You really just have to hang way far in the back and shoot the same thing at the same time, and it really is quite simple. Again, chain the Ursas back to back. It's a standard format that just works for everything, and just take it slow. If you're team shooting and calling out what champion you're working on, you should be totally fine. As you can see in this room, we kind of like to hang out on the upper level here and just focus on one champion at a time together. The Warlock finished all of them for us, and so we were able to go into the boss fight with full heavy, which was really nice. I also highly recommend going to the boss room with full super energy, so if you need to, just hang back in this room and wait for your supers to charge up. It's well worth it. Once you get down there, the boss's sniper attack or ground pound attack can kill you in one shot, so you really need to stay away from that. Once you enter the boss room, go to your right side and hang out there, hiding behind the pillars, but not getting too close to the pillars because they do give off electric shock. You can also hang back in the far corners of the room. But once those electric pillars spawn that are kind of moving down the track, you need to stay far away from those because those will one hit you too. After you get a boss damage phase to go away, it's going to spawn a barrier champion. Take your time killing the barrier champion, killing Shanks too, and chaining your ursas back to back. And then after you kill that barrier champion, it's going to cause the boss to come chase you down a little bit more with the ground pound and the sniper attack. After you've gone through two barrier champions, you're going to get the boss to go into the phase that you currently see on screen here. You're going to want to retreat to this back area here where these big shields raise up because they provide excellent cover. Give it everything you got to just melt the boss down because the new melee attack coming at the end of this damage phase is very deadly. All in all, this nightfall is not that difficult and I have faith that you can absolutely complete it. Good luck out there, Guardians, and next week I'll have a new Grandmaster video for whatever that one is. Sorry this one was a bit later, but I really like to make sure that they're polished before I actually put them out. Okay, thanks for stopping by. Good luck. Catch you in the next one. I'll leave you with this incredible clip we got when trying to film this video. We had a spawn. We're getting good at this. Oh.
Oh my god. The timing. Holy what? Shit. Wow.
What happened?
That's so funny.
Oh my god.